the threat of flooding is mostly gone in Plaquemines Parish. State and local officials continue to put up those HESCO baskets today near Myrtle Grove.
And parish officials say that the barrier will remain along that 3-mile stretch of Highway 23 for the rest of the 2012 hurricane season. Reporter Blake Hansen tells us not everyone is happy with the parish's plan.
Workers were up early Monday, many just happy they weren't still up working from the night before.
But they were prepared to work through the night to put the sandbags on the back levee and finish this project had we needed to, so we were able to give them a little break.
But not everyone is pleased with their work. Just a hop, skip, and a levee away sits the home of Mike Strohmeyer. It's inside the Myrtle Grove subdivision, outside the levee walls. But he says despite Katrina, Ike, and Gustav, the area didn't start flooding until last year.
People had 1, 2, 3, 4 inches of water in their homes as a result of the parish raising these levees.
So Strohmeyer and his neighbors in the Homeowners Association hired an attorney. They want a floodgate instead of higher levees.
I know Billy very well and does an outstanding job. I don't know why he insists on raising these levees around the subdivision.
Nungesser says he has heard the residents' concerns and in response has hired a company to look at the cost of building up the levee versus putting a floodgate in this canal. Strohmeyer also blames the environment.
This pipeline canal where I held my thumb,
uh-huh,
is probably where the erosion is. Some of these bays no longer exist.
With a major storm, you cannot keep the water out of the parish because there's been so much coastal erosion, there's just nothing to stop the surge.
One thing everyone agrees on, they're lucky Debbie didn't come their way.
We're going to stay on our toes so it's well ashore, but it appears we've dodged a bullet on this one.
Now the disagreement continues over how to prepare for the future. On your side in Myrtle Grove, Blake Hansen, WDSU News.